You have $1,000 to invest. Remember MetroCoffee and Daily Brew from our PE ratio and PEG ratio videos. MetroCoffee trades at $15 with a PE of 15 and a 5% growth, giving it a PEG ratio of 3. Daily Brew trades at $48 with a PE of 24 and 30% growth, giving it a PEG ratio of 0.8. Most investors would pick Daily Brew because of the lower PEG, and honestly, that's not a bad choice. But Peter Lynch, the legendary investor, knew PEG was missing something. It ignored dividends. He created PEGY, which inserts dividends into the equation and changes the whole picture. Hi, I am Nick, the guy with the Greek accent, a long-time value investor and financial educator. And to my fellow intelligent investors, stick with me, and by the end of this video, you'll know why we use PEGY to spot big winners. So what exactly is the PEGY ratio, and why should you care? PEGY stands for price to earnings to growth to yield. It is the PEG ratio with one crucial addition, dividend yield. Here is the formula. You take the PE ratio and divide it by the sum of the earnings growth rate plus the dividend yield. If you are not fully comfortable with PE or PEG ratios yet, I recommend watching my two videos that explain them step by step. Click on the cards above. It will make PEGY much easier to follow, and you'll get a clear idea of why it is so useful. So, how to use the PEGY ratio? The key rule is that the lower the PEGY ratio, the better the potential bargain, with a number below 1 suggesting the stock might be undervalued. Peter Lynch, the legendary manager of the Fidelity Magellan Fund, invented this ratio, and his track record speaks for itself. 29% average annual returns for 13 straight years, turning him into one of the most successful investors of all time. So that's not just theory. PEGY is a tool that helped a real investor make extraordinary returns in the real world. In the early 80s, Peter Lynch noticed Wall Street was obsessed with high-growth tech stocks and ignoring solid dividend-paying companies in boring industries. He saw the flaw. The PEG ratio treated a company growing at 15% with a 5% dividend the same as one growing at 15% with zero dividends. But you are clearly better off getting paid cash while you wait for growth. That realization led him to create PEGY, a tool that helped him consistently find undervalued stocks that delivered both growth and income. Let me show you why this matters with our two companies. Daily Brew has an attractive PEG ratio of 0.8, right? But here is the thing. They pay zero dividends. They are reinvesting everything back into growth. So their PEG ratio? Still 0.8. Now, MetroCoffee is different. Yes, they only have 5% growth, but they pay a generous 10% dividend yield. Watch what happens when we calculate their PEGY. PE of 15 divided by growth plus yield. So, 15 divided by 15 gives us a PEGY ratio of 1. Suddenly, MetroCoffee looks a lot more attractive, doesn't it? That 10% dividend yield means $100 in cash in your pocket every year on your $1,000 investment while you wait for growth. Pretty tempting, right? So which would you pick? Daily Brew at 0.8 or MetroCoffee at 1? Keep that choice in mind because we are coming back to it. One crucial rule when using PEGY: always compare companies from the same industry. Why? Because different industries have completely different growth and dividend patterns. Tech companies typically reinvest everything for growth and pay zero dividends. Utility companies grow slowly but pay high dividends. Comparing a tech stock to a utility using PEGY is like comparing apples to oranges. The numbers won't tell you which is better, only which fits its industry pattern. That's why our next example uses two automakers going head-to-head. Same industry, same challenges, but very different PEGY stories. Let's calculate the PEGY ratio for Ford and General Motors. Ford's PE for 2024 profits is 9. The expected growth for the next 5 years is 14%, and the PEGY ratio is 0.64. General Motors, on the other hand, has a PE of 11.3, and estimated growth rate of 17%, and a PEGY ratio of 0.65. We have a tie. But now let's factor in dividends, because that's exactly where PEGY shines. Ford pays a dividend yield of about 4.5%, while General Motors offers only 1%. Now let's calculate PEGY for both. For Ford, PE of 9 over 14% growth plus 4.5% dividend gives us 0.49. General Motors, PE of 11.3 over 17% growth plus 1% dividend gives us 0.63. Look at that. When you include the dividend, Ford suddenly becomes the more attractive investment, even though their PEG ratios alone made it seem like a tie. The PEGY difference reveals how these companies create shareholder value differently. General Motors' 1% dividend means they are reinvesting heavily, betting on that 17% growth from electric vehicles and market expansion. Ford's 4.5% dividend shows they are balancing growth with immediate cash returns, saying we will grow at 14%, but we will also pay you while you wait. This is the strategic insight PEGY provides. It forces you to think about how a company is choosing to create shareholder value, not just whether the stock price is cheap. So here is how you can approach investing in stocks. Start with the PE ratio to get a basic sense of the stock's valuation. Next, check the PEGY ratio to see if the company's growth justifies its price. Finally, look at the PEGY ratio to get the full picture, including dividends. But even with a low PEGY, some companies can still trap your money. Let's see why. Remember MetroCoffee from earlier? PEGY of 1, paying that juicy 10% dividend yield. Looks attractive, right? But ask yourself, why is a company paying out such a high dividend when they are only growing at 5%? Is that a bargain or a warning sign? Ford's 4.5% dividend combined with 14% growth tells a different story than MetroCoffee's 10% dividend with 5% growth. One company is returning cash while growing. The other might be paying dividends because it has nowhere else to invest. Maybe MetroCoffee is a value trap. And value traps don't just underperform. They destroy capital through dividend cuts and falling stock prices, while you wait for a recovery that never comes. That's exactly what we are covering in the next video. Click on this card to watch it now. And look, if you have watched this entire video, you are serious about investing the right way. That puts you in rare company. But here's the truth. You can't fully evaluate dividend-paying stocks without deeply understanding how dividends really work, when they help, when they hurt, and what they mean for your returns. Click the card to watch our dividends video now.